Let's see this question, which says evaluate integral 0 to pi by 2 sin x upon 1 plus cos square x. Again, what is the relation between cos and sine? I know that they are related by differentiation, that cos x differentiation is minus sin x dx. So, I'll be using that knowledge. Now, let me go by substitution again. So, by substitution, I can say that my solution would go as let cos x is equal to t, that means minus sin x dx is equal to dt. And if my question is I can go for the further steps. So if I name this as equation number 1 combined, I know that now my I would change. My I would become sin x dx as minus dt and 1 plus cos square x as 1 plus t square. But since I have substituted, I cannot go directly. I have to change the limits also. So I write when my x is equal to 0, because the lower limit was 0. What is my t? That is cos 0. So cos 0 is 1. And when my x is equal to pi by 2, what is my t? It is cos pi by 2, which is 0. So my limits are going now from 1 to 0. So that is from 1 to 0 I'll be going. Don't make it 0 to 1. Lower limit has to remain lower limit. It does not make any difference that 1 is greater than 0, so it should not come downwards. It is not like that, right? Now see, I take minus common, so again 1 to 0 dt upon 1 plus t square. I told you formulas are important. So 1 plus t square or t square plus 1 square. So it becomes minus 1 by a tan inverse x by a plus c, earlier in indefinite, but here it is limits. So, no need of plus c, directly write minus here, tan inverse 0 minus tan inverse 1. So, minus outside, tan inverse 0 is 0, tan inverse 1 is pi by 4, because tan 45 degrees 1. Now, minus minus becomes plus, so it is minus minus pi by 4. So, the answer is not minus minus, but only pi by 4. So, that is how you have to do this kind of a question, which involves substitution and definite integration.